time. Tomorrow I'm joined by Kurt, but more excitingly, we're here with Jun and Junko. Jun, you're a producer on Dragon Ball Sparking Zero, and you are our lovely translator for this. Thank you for joining us, and thank you for bringing Dragon Ball to show off to us. I'm a huge Dragon Ball fan, so this is very exciting for me. I'm a huge Dragon Ball player as well, and it's returning to a format that I really love. So can you tell us a little bit about going back to this kind of like 3D fighting game approach? What was the kind of thinking with that?
ドラゴンボールの大ファンなので、で今回スパークルゼロは 3D バトルを中心にしたっていうの、なんでそのバトル系になったんでしょうか。あ今回のスパーキー、はい、その 3D バトル4、うん、なんで 3D バトルにしようと思ったんですか。今回のスパークルゼロ。
そうですね、スパーキングゼロは実は武道会展開シリーズという名前でこれまでアメリカでは出させていただいているゲームになっていまして、それのシリーズ作品になっています。で過去も 3D での対戦格闘ゲームだったので、今回も対戦 3D でのアクションゲームにはなっています。
Yeah, so this is part of the Budokai Tenkaichi series. Mm-hmm. And in the past, you know, we actually wanted to honor that 3D battling that was already part of the series. So that's why we're in 3D battle.
It's been so long since we've had this style of Dragon Ball fighting game. We've had so many other Dragon Ball fighting games since then. Why now? Like, why is this moment to kind of bring this back and like attempt this gameplay? And has there been, are you staying close to it, to the original format, or how are you changing up now?
そうですね、前作が出たのが17年前とかそれぐらい、結構時間が経ってるんですね。そこからかなり時間も空いて、ただ昔の出ていた作品でも非常に多くの方が遊んでいただいていたファンの方も多くいらっしゃったので、今作時間が空いたところではあるんですけれども、その方々が満足いただけるようにしっかりとシリーズとしてのバトルシステムは同じく踏襲させていただいていて、近い感覚できっとプレイいただけるというふうには思っています。
Yeah, so, you know, as we mentioned the last time, the part of the series is out is about 17 years ago. And during that time, there were so many fans. So we really, really focused on making sure those fans are satisfied with the series of battles you can play in Sparking Zero.
So obviously the original games they had, they were very faithful to the source material in terms of the characters that were represented, which means various forms of Goku. And since like the last game, that has only increased, and now there's more Gokus than ever. There's more, you know, different Vegetas. You've got more characters now. What was the process like in picking who's going to be involved? Was it a case of just being like, we want to get everyone, or is it a case of, let's be selective, we want, you know, this character from Super or whatever it may be? How did you approach that process?
そうですね、今回ドラゴンボールスーパーからもたくさんキャラクターが出ているというところで、もちろん原作作中の中で活躍していたキャラクターというのを中心に今回当然実装させていただいていますし、シリーズの作品であるというところもあるので、なので過去の武道会展開地3であったような形で悟空だけでも当時と同じような形で、悟空の前期中期後期、アーリーミドルですかレイトですかね、みたいなものも作らせていただいて、過去に遊んでいた人たちが懐かしかったり、慣れているのでより遊びやすかったりというところも意識しながらキャラクターというのは決めさせていただきました。
Yeah, so, so of course we did choose all the characters centered around the classics, of course, and there's also characters from Dragon Ball Super. And we felt that the fans from Budokai Tenkaichi 3, they'll remember, you know, being able to play Goku in his like earlier stage, mid stage, you know, late stage in his story, and we're hoping that those fans will really get nostalgic about BT3 when they played that. So so that's kind of very fan centered thinking when we were choosing characters.
Yeah, how are you approaching kind of like obviously the heart of these games is always like fighting with your friends and that kind of stuff, but for some people they love the kind of like the story mode arcade stuff, that kind of thing. How are you approaching that element of it? Obviously fighting games aren't traditionally super heavy on story, but more recently they have been, and Dragon Ball has a rich history of narrative. How are you approaching that element of it?
ドラゴンボールっていうのは大体ストーリー性があるんですけれども、ストーリーに対しては今回どういうふうなものなんでしょうか。
そうですね、今回 まあ、基本的にはそのエピソードバトルというモードがあるんですけれども、そこではその原作で見たようなシチュエーションでのバトルを楽しめるモードに今回作らせていただいています。で特にあの、まあ、長いキャラクター、ストーリーのボリュームの多いキャラクターと、まあ、悟空なんですけれども、まあ、ラディッツ編のところからですね、あの ラディッツが襲来する、やってくるところからですね、ドラゴンボールスーパーのところまで今回遊んでいただけるようにしています。なので基本的には原作で、まあ、見たようなシチュエーションでのバトルを楽しめるモードに学っているというものですね。
Yeah, so currently when it comes to that narrative aspect, you can experience that through episode battles mode, and that actually makes you immersed in those iconic battles from the series. And characters such as Goku, like you mentioned, has a lot of content when it comes to Goku. You know, even with that, within the episode battle, you go from like Raditz appearing all the way to Dragon Ball Super, yeah. narrative.
Right.
So I think as you mentioned, Junko, it's been 17 years. Since the original series, and obviously, like, you know, those were PS2, I think there was one on the Wii, and we've had so many console generations since, and like being able to, like, right now we're seeing on the screen like a full city battle, and I kind of want to know, like, you know, were there very specific episodes I'm sure you're taking inspiration from, but where is, you know, like, how are you using like new technology, a new way to like try and show the scope and power of a fight in Dragon Ball that maybe like the 2D games don't do quite as well, or do, I'm sorry, do in their own way.
やっぱりあの二次元ゲームで、あとはまあ昔 PS2 とか Wii で遊べた頃と比べて、やっぱり2024年の技術、あとプラットフォームでやっぱり街の破壊とかはどういうふうにそのもっとすごい体感あのアップになったんでしょうか、スパーキングゼロでは。
そうですね、あの、まあ、街だけに限らずですね、今回アンリアルエンジン5も使わせていただいて、まあ、リアルタイムでその悟空たちの持つ超パワーを体験表現できるような形でですね、ゲームの方は作らせていただきました。なのでビルとかもあの戦いの余波で激しくドカーンと壊れたりもするですし、他にもですね、あのちょっと気をためるだけで草木がバタバタと揺れたりだとか、もう天気まで変わったりとかっていうところまで今回リアルタイムに楽しんでいただけるように今なっています。
So we've utilized, we're on Unreal Engine 5, so we can really grasp those battles in real time. So yes, in the cities there will be massive destruction, and even when any of our characters, if they're able to when they're recharging their ki, you can actually see the blades of grass starting to move, the weather changing, the trees moving. So, it's a lot more of a...immersive experience thanks to the technology.
Obviously when you look at trailers of it and videos of it, it looks like it plays like a classic game. What are the kind of gameplay changes, additions, tweaks that you have done that might not be visible from a trailer just watching it?
そうですね、スパーキングシリーズは 3D 対戦アクションとして作っているもので、特にやっぱりドラゴンボールの作品自体、あのすごい三次元的で縦横無尽にすごい超スピードで戦うっていうような作品になっていますし、それを自分の手で本当に操作しながら生み出すことができる、超高速で相手を移動してあの翻弄したりみたいなこともできますし、やっぱりそういうドラゴンボールらしいアクションというのをその手でリアルタイムに生み出せるっていうところが、このスパーキングシリーズ、武道会展開シリーズの魅力というふうに私たちは考えています。
Yeah, we think that what's really especially great about Sparking Zero is that it is, like we mentioned, 3D battle, and the fact that you can control all their movements and how, you know, they're super fast speed, and you can actually control all that and experience it. So I think that's one of the things that's really exciting about it.
Yeah. As a huge fan, obviously the voices of these characters are very, very important. What's kind of been the system and approach in bringing those voices back? Are you kind of taking previously recorded stuff and reusing it, which might sound bad, but as someone who loves Dragon Ball, sounds perfect to me. I want to hear him say Kamehameha exactly how I remember it, but what's the approach for audio and that kind of stuff?
を聞くのはファンとしては大歓迎なんですけど、はい、なので声優さんとかはどういうふうに今回なされるんですか？
そうですね、そこはちょっとあの私の方からじゃなかなか申し上げられる部分ではないので、ちょっとここで差し控えさせていただけたらなんですけど。
Yeah, actually, that's an area that is a bit out of scope for, yeah.
Oh, okay, that's right fine. It's a little bit of a secret. I'm excited to see it. Yeah. In terms of the multiplayer stuff, we have the classic battles. What are the other kind of formats that are going to be available in terms of the combat stuff beyond just the one-on-one fight? Usually, you have a little extra flavor in there as well.
バトルの、バトルの種類はマルチプレイ、まあ一応まあ1対1は基本ですけれども、他にはどんな、バトル対戦があるんですか？フォーマット
基本的にお客さんはその1対1、プレイヤーは2人ですね、1対1の対戦が基本的になっていまして、その中で、まあ、チームでその最大5人までメンバーを選んで、まあ、バトルすることができるというのが基本的なバトルシステムにはなります。
Yeah, so, at the core of it is, player versus player, but then you can also create teams, a maximum of five
five
players, and battle out that way.
Yeah, that sounds like you can recreate classic moments, I guess. Yeah. Can you talk a little bit about the online component? Because obviously the previous game in the series or spiritual successors, predecessors, didn't have much of an online component. Can you talk a little bit about how online is implemented? Is it going to be, you know, available? How are you working with that?
やっぱ過去の作品はオンラインっていうのはそんなになかったので、うん、スパーキングゼロはオンラインでは何が あるランクなんですか、はい、
そうですね、フレンド同士で楽しむことのできる当然対戦もありますし、まあ、ランクマッチという形で強さをどんどん自分で上を目指していくっていう遊び方もできるようになります。
Yeah, so there is, you know, playing with friends, and then there will be ranked matches as well.
Oh, fantastic. That sounds cool.
I'm super excited about the idea. I'm so fixated on like the destruction aspect of it, and like being able to see like the scope of these fights, because it's such an iconic thing when you get to watch it in an anime, but playing it is a different story. And I was curious if there was like a specific character or thing or even combination of characters that you love to watch like destroy cities or punch through mountains, and like what's that like to be able to like, fulfill that fantasy?
古谷さん自身、うん、このキャラクターを都会を破壊するとき見る場面が好きとか、そういった、はい、迫力ある、はい、まあ、シーンかキャラクターの要素ってありますか、うん、
そうですね、まあ、ちょっと、まあ、戦いの上で壊れていくというところで都市を壊すためにというわけではないんですけれども、そうですね、例えばブロリーなんかは周囲にこう木で爆発して周囲を一気にこう攻撃することができる技を持っていますし、悟空 のアルティメットブラスト、一番強い必殺技ですね、でいうとすごい木を体の周りに放ちながら放つすごいカメハメハを打つことができて、まあ、かなり盛大にグラフィック表現含めて気持ちの良い表現になっているんじゃないかなというふうには思います。
Yeah, so I would, for, as examples, I would say Broly. His explosive move actually explodes, you know, around him.So that's very destructive, but Goku, you know, Goku's ultimate blast, you know, when he's any of the Kamehamehas, I think the graphics that we're offering now with yeah. Sparking Zero is just, it just will feel so much better just yeah. to really feel that, all that power.
On the flip side, how do you approach characters that don't have that much destructive power and continue to make them...fun and interesting? Everyone loves to make fun of him, but some people still love Yamcha, but he doesn't quite have the destructive power of other characters. So how do you approach kind of ensuring that if you decided you want to play Yamcha, it's still fun and there's a lot to like, you know, see and feel with him?
逆に例えばヤムチャみたいな、そんなに破壊力がつざましくないキャラクターはどういうふうに工夫してプレイしたいなというような、
そうですね、まあ、ヤムチャでいうと、まあ、ヤムチャもカメハメハが使えたりするので、結構やっぱパワフルな力を持っているキャラクターにはなりますし、その中でも特徴的な近接攻撃でのローガ風風拳という技だったりとか、まあ、超必殺技、早期弾という相手に攻撃して、木の弾をバシバシと相手にぶつけるような技とかもできますし、やっぱりキャラクターらしいアクションというのを楽しんでいただけるようなキャラクターにはなっています。
Yeah, so, you know, even Yamcha.He still can do Kamehameha.
A little bit.
So he still has, yeah, he still has, he can still do that. But a lot of close combat, he has very specific, moves that he can do, including, you know, multiple energy attacks, things like that. Yeah. So we have made sure to really know and understand the specific qualities of our characters.
まあ、ヤムチャに限らずですけど、他にも例えばクリリンとかであれば、まあ、太陽拳って相手の目をくらませて あの隙を作る技も使えますし、残像剣みたいなもので相手の攻撃をまあ、うまく自分の残像を使って回避するみたいな技もあったりして、そういう撹乱をしながら戦うキャラクターもいたりしますし、まあ、そのキャラクターらしい戦い方をそれぞれ楽しんでいただけるようにはなっているかなと思います。
And even Kuririn, you know, he has a solar blast that blinds everyone. He also has counter attacks. So, so yeah, being very knowing our characters really well.
Yeah.
And to bring out their qualities.
Yeah. But I'm very glad to see the game back, and it's definitely evoking my nostalgia. Thank you so much, Junko, for joining us on the show and bringing Dragon Ball to us. It's hopefully going to be seeing more of it at the show. But yeah, thank you for everyone to watch, for watching.